Agbare voorzitter, dear E, honorable president, there's nothing wrong to have dreams. In fact, I do believe that real political leaders must have dreams. But then we must say to each other, it must be dreams to last forever. That's the difference. Chairperson, every time I delivered a speech from this podium in previous SONAS, congratulating the Honourable President with his election, I said that the Freedom Front Plus and its supporters wants to build South Africa. We want to build a better future for all. In your campaign, Honourable President, you said at Stellenbosch that you wish you could tie the white young people of South Africa to a tree, preventing them from leaving South Africa. But did you ever ask yourself, why do the white people and the young people of South Africa leave South Africa? It is because they don't get jobs. And they don't get jobs because of affirmative action. You say that you want to utilize their skills and their expertise. The fact of the matter is you cannot do it. Because of affirmative action, they have to go and seek jobs at other places in the world. And yes, the world reap those expertise from the people and the young people of South Africa. Still, you discriminate against the young white people of South Africa. Your own youth employment scheme. White young people cannot participate in it. Because they are white. If you go and look, for instance, what your Secretary General Ysma Gesula says, he is still blaming the white people of white monopoly capital. His argument is it is still because of the white people that we cannot have economic growth. Chairperson, with great respect, that is a kick in the teeth of those people who really wants to build South Africa. Do you want to recognize them? Do you want to enslave the young people and the white young people of South Africa? Because if you think you can enslave them, you are completely wrong. If you look at your MEC for Education in Gauteng, always blaming Afrikaans schools for his own failures and using it as a smokescreen instead of attend to the schools who are real problems. Do the ANC have a problem with my mother tongue language of Afrikaans? Because that is what Lesufi says. But I didn't see, Honorable President, that you repudiated him. I said before, do away with black economic empowerment. And can I say, I'm supported by black academics like William Gumede. You know, in the election time, when I put in some petrol in my car, the attendant said to me, I'm going to vote for you. And I asked, why? And he said, you are quite correct. When it comes to black economic empowerment, it is only favoring the political elite. So, I want to come and say you want to build the economy. How can you build the economy if you have a construction mafia stopping 74 construction projects demanding a 30% shareholding in the company? How can you build the economy if more than 110 engineers in the construction business left South Africa because of this crime elements in South Africa? I want to say to you today, if you don't curb these criminal activities, you will not be able to build the economy. More than 16 trucks burned over a weekend. The people that keeps the economy rolling, but they burn them and people lose their lives because of crime in South Africa. Chairperson, you will have to ensure that if you want the economy to grow, that you curb the powers of the unions. You know, and everybody in South Africa know, when it comes to the SOEs in South Africa, you have to retrench people. But the unions come to you and the ANC and says, you will not do that. And that is part of the problem. You will have to curb their powers. You will have to revise labor laws in South Africa. Chairperson, I come to cry. And I want to ask you, why is it so difficult to publicly condemn farm murders in South Africa? In South Africa, we have black farmers, we have colored farmers, we have Indian farmers, we have white farmers. The food you had this morning when you had breakfast, you must thank the farmers. Everybody who is going to have lunch just now, thank the farmers. Chairperson, ek wil vir die agbare president sê, verlede jaar ongeveer hierdie tyd, was daar aanvalle gewees op moskeeën, een in KwaZulu-Natal en een in Mamasbury. U tree onmiddellik op. U benoem onmiddellik 'n presidensiële komitee van die minister van polisie, van verdediging en van justisie. Ek wil vandag vir u sê, 'n plaasmoord is nie 'n moord op 'n individu nie. It's not only a crime against an individual, it's a crime against the community. It is the women and children who pay the price of a farm murder, where they are tortured, where they throw boiling water down their throats, where they take hot irons burning the women, where they force a 12-year girl to see how her mother is raped. That's torture. But still, you do refuse to publicly condemn farm murders. I appeal to you. It's simple. And I will say to you, Honorable President, I will invite you to a funeral of a farm murder, and you invite me to any other funeral you wish to. Lastly, Chairperson, I want to say there's one outstanding matter. That is Section 235 of the Constitution that deals with self-determination. It also determines that national legislation have to determine what happens with Section 235. There's an accord between the Freedom Front, the African National Congress, and the government in 1994. Chairperson, I appeal to you that we meet, that we take this step forward to ensure that Section 235 of the Constitution, which deals with self-determination, taken forward. Ek dink dit is die enigste artikel in die grondwet wat bepaal dat nasionale wetgewing wel geskryf moet word wat nog nie geskryf is nie. So in daardie opsig het ons ook 'n grondwetlike verantwoordelikheid en plig. Agbare president, ek wil afsluit. You know there's a song that says it's actually the green green grass of home. It's about this prisoner who sang and he thought in his song, I want to touch the green, green grass of home. And then he says, and when I wake and I look around me, I was surrounded by four great walls. And yes, I then realized that I was only dreaming. Because he's a prisoner. Honorable President, you are a prisoner of the African National Congress. Break away from that. Then you can save South Africa. Then you can save the economy. I thank you.